Hey everyone, my name is Nathan, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create and sell your training programs online. Now, if you're new to ABC Trainerize, you're likely wondering how to make some extra coin. As most coaches are when they go online, it's a little bit confusing. So what I'm going to do is show you how to build the program first, starting by going into our master libraries and into our programs, and then taking that program and putting it either onto your website or your social media. So let's dive in. What we're going to do is click New Program. Now, depending on the version of Trainerize that you have, you'll have a couple options. If you have the video add-on, you'll see the on-demand workout library, and that's really just like our Netflix-style workout library that includes anything over 5 minutes up to an hour. If you have a lot of on-demand videos or follow-along workouts, that's the type of library you're probably going to want to sell. But for most of you, what you're doing is giving people a phased training program. And for a lot of us, it's just a strength training program, and you can build this out as far in advance as you want, but the client will only see, let's say, a month at a time. So it's up to you how you want to do that. Now, what we're going to do is start by entering our name. We'll just do sample program for sale. I'm going to make it a simple 3 month block, and then we're going to keep it in the shared folder. So we'll hit save. Now, what our programs are consisting of is generally workouts. So what we're going to do is build out a few different workouts to show you. So I'll start with sample A, let's call it strength training. And it's going to be a regular workout, typically going to be the ones where you do strength training specifically. If you'd rather give them more of a circuit-based program, you'll see here you have that option. And that's going to be more of a list view where they're just going to be logging reps rather than their weights. And then for your interval type of training, this is the one that would actually have a video playing alongside a timer. You see that over there. But for a majority of people, what they're going to be doing is regular workouts. So let's start with that. I'll hit start. And I'm just going to move this out of the way here so you can see what's going on. So within the workout builder, you got a few options, but the majority of it starts with taking whatever exercise you're looking for. So type it in here. You can use our standard library of exercises, or you could even use a YouTube suggestion. So if you have a specific exercise that you can't find in our library, you have that option. Or you can always add your own custom exercises simply by dragging and dropping a video in here. And you have some different options on how you want to tag it. But the idea is that once your library is built out, it becomes really easy to then drag and drop all the exercises that you're going to put in this program, or specifically this workout. So at the top, usually what I'll do is I'll say like superset A is your warm up, just to give them an idea. If I'm doing something specific, like for example, a cluster set, I'll say 2x4 equals 2 mini sets of 4. So just little instructions that are going to help them through this workout would always be started here. And then the actual design of the workout, I'm going to say, let's say 3 sets on the left, I have 8 reps. I'm going to maybe include some RPE and some tempo, and that way they know exactly how to perform the exercise. So assuming you have everything built out the way you want, you have your supersets, you have your rest periods, your rep sets, all of that, we're going to save this exercise in this program. And then let's just say for time's sake, I'm going to import some sort of workout from somewhere else in our library just to save me some time. So maybe I take some of the video workouts that we have, or this anti-desk upper back sequence. I personally work with desk workers, so this is a good example of what I might give them. And now that I have all these workouts, now I can deliver a program. So the way I'm going to look at it is I can either schedule it here and just build out like every Monday they're going to be doing this workout, or if I want to scroll down to the actual program that we're looking at, you'll see you have the option to go into a calendar view instead. And that makes things a little bit easier in terms of scheduling. So I could go select from this program. I'm going to select that video workout that I showed you. I'm going to set up a repeat. Let's go every Tuesday and Thursday they're going to be doing this for the next 4 weeks. And then it's going to go and schedule those out for me. So now I've got the makings of a program, which is essentially their schedule started. And now what you want to do is start to include other elements like messages, for example. So let's say day one, they log in. I want them to receive a warm welcome message from me as their coach. I'm just gonna put this as welcome message. Say, hey, maybe include a auto field, like their first name. So we'll customize it. Welcome to the plan. And then so on and so forth. So you can schedule a few different messages here. Once you're happy with that. So once I've got the auto message scheduled, I'm going to click schedule, add it in. And now on day one, they're gonna receive that welcome message. So usually what I'll do is I'll have a series of messages within the program. Like on day two, I'll have another auto message that includes, let's say, a file, like a PDF with instructions on how to do the plan. And I'll just say, hey, client, here's your game plan. Read it over and let me know if questions. Excuse the errors. We're just going to follow along with that. So I've added that in. So now you can see that the program has taken shape so that the client has a series of workouts. They have a series of messages. They have things like progress tracking built in. So we have a progress photo and weight measurement, inch measurement, a folder for them to put everything in there. And the idea is that once this program is live, you don't have to do much. Everything will kind of run itself. And that's really what we want to continue with. So again, you have workouts, cardio, progress tracking, messages. All of these can be pre-built. And so if your specific workouts, you wanted to do that for every single program, or in other words, you want to do that for each phase. And then once you finish that, now we can move on and actually sell the program. So assuming you've done all of these and you've got it done, I want you to follow along over here to payments. Awesome. So first steps first, if you are new to Trainerize or you haven't used Stripe before, you will need to create a Stripe account prior to setting this up on Trainerize. So what I'd encourage you to do is follow the help link in the article below. We'll include it in the show notes and make sure that your integration is set up here. You'll see it get started and you'll be able to do products at that point. Now, assuming you have that set up already, let's jump into products. We're gonna go into add product next. And this is really where the magic happens. So we'll say sample program, 60-day weight loss. So you would include a little description, lose 10 pounds in 60 days. Maybe you include a photo over here. And then you wanna decide what kind of product is this? Is it a one-time fee? If so, how much are you charging? And how long will this be available for the client? So if it's in perpetuity, you might just put 99, or if it's limited to a year, you can put it to 12, up to you. Then you also wanna decide when do they receive that program? For most of us, it's day of purchase, but sometimes people do cohorts, in which case you might do like next Monday or on a fixed start date. And then you have the option here, if you'd like to use our live video calls, you can add in sessions as well and decide how many live calls are they gonna get with you. But again, for most of us, if it's just a program, we can skip that step. You do wanna sell it on Trainerize Me, which is our network or our community of trainers, and it allows clients to find coaches in their area or who solve specific problems. So it's just another source of advertising and it's free. And then lastly, you want to set up your automation here. So you want to decide what kind of client are they going to become? Are they going to be able to message you or not? If the answer is no, then it's just one-way messaging, like you messaging them. Will they be assigned to you or someone else on your team? Then, of course, the program that you just built, you're going to go look for that. Add this program as their main program. And then if you want to give them any bonus content, that's where these add-on programs come in. You can select as many as you want. Maybe you give them some educational videos or a mobility program to do on the side. But if it's just the program you're selling, you would keep it to main program. Then I've also helpfully have some tags in here, like beginner. And that way you can message all the beginners at once. Keep that. You have the option to include a little meal plan PDF if that's your thing. If not, leave it blank. They won't see any nutrition. And then finally, you have the option to add them into a group here. So if you want to have some sort of WhatsApp, Facebook type group, you could have a challenge going, or you could just have a support group for them to chat with each other, however you want to frame it. But again, if you don't put it there, they won't see it. keep in mind, this is the first purchase option. So if they're already an existing client, you want to repeat that to include what happens if this specific product starts. So keep in mind, if they are an existing customer, you probably only want to do this as an add-on program so you don't disrupt what they're doing already. For example, if they'd already purchased a program with you and this is their second, you don't want this to completely take over. So you want to have it now as an add-on on top of their existing program. However, if they're new or they've expired and they're starting fresh, that's when this main program would be the choice you want to make. And finally, here under product ends, you just want to keep in mind what will happen if their payment goes delinquent or if the product expires. These are the steps that will automatically be carried out. So for most of the time, it'll be setting them to basic, which means they can still have access to the app, but they don't have any content. It just allows you to message them, but they won't see anything else. Or you can completely boot them out and put them to offline. Again, if you don't want them to have access, just unsubscribe them and remove them from anything else. So once I'm happy with that, I'll hit save. Oh, forgot to add myself here. Hit save. I'm going to zoom out so you can see this. And add. All right, let's jump back in here. So now that I have that program, I'll look for my sample program. I can sell it. So move this out of the way. You've got a couple options. If they're an existing member in Trainerize, you can sell it directly to them. If they already have their credit card uploaded, you can extend an offer to purchase within Trainerize. So you just hit sell. The alternative, which most of us are using, is to create a checkout link and to copy that. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to our website and either put it in a hyperlink. So most websites like a Wix or a Squarespace, when you go to a certain button like join now or purchase now, you can put a direct link to this checkout link that I just created. And I'll show you what that looks like instead. So we're going to punch that in. And so this would be the checkout page that the client would see. Now keep in mind, this is a trial account, so it looks a little bit different, but essentially, once you have this checkout link that I just added here in the URL, you can hyperlink it. So anytime someone purchases, you would be able to sell that product without even being there. All they need to do is input their credit card, name, email, and then they would be sent a link from Trainerize to download the app with their own custom login info. They would go through your onboarding process. And then once they open the app, they would have the program associated with this product. So a few ways to do it. You can sell in-app, sending them a link directly. You can send them to a checkout link, or you can also link this checkout link to your social media and put it in your link tree or whichever source you use. So hopefully this helps. Come back to here. As a reminder, we go programs, build the program, then you go to products, add a product, and connect that program to your product. And then it's just a matter of making it available for your clients. Thanks so much for watching. My name is Nathan. And if you have any follow-up questions, please do not hesitate to reach out to help.trainerize@abcfitness.com to have your questions answered a little bit faster. Thanks so much.